Well, the topics that people were working on at Princeton, in retrospect, I suppose one can see that they were all parts of some big interactive puzzle. I mean, Bott's work on Lie groups and Morse theory has had a long subsequent history impact on things, and from that I learned a lot about Lie groups and their details. Serre's work on algebraic geometry and sheaf cohomology was being developed in a particular direction and then developed subsequently other ways. I think the other big strand was the work of Kodaira and Spencer, which was the other part of the sheaf cohomology from the analytical point of view, which they were doing kind of in parallel to Serre. And Kodaira was giving lectures at the university on the detailed applications to the poly-algebraic surfaces, currents on surfaces, and the things that which eventually led to his proof of the fact that Hodge manifolds are algebraic. So he was applying the sheaf cohomology in great detail to theories of families of curves on surfaces and so on. And then there was Hirzebruch, and he was giving lectures which are, he'd sort of the Riemann-Roch theorem and all the background of that. So those are the kind of corpus of ideas, which were sort of Lie groups, sheaf cohomology, algebraic version of it, analytical version of it, and all the the whole formalism of characteristic classes, which Hitzelberg put together. And of course, there was the papers of Borel and Hitzelberg on characteristic classes, which emerged later, which became kind of the lingua franca of everybody working in the area. So it was really a whole collection of interrelated ideas, which have all somehow come to maturity more or less around the same time. And there were all these young, very active people doing them. That really made the whole intellectual climate. I mean, maybe other things going on as well, but that's the bit that sort of impacted on me and a lot of people involved with it. And it, I think it was the dominating factor at the Institute at that time. And many young people, other visitors took part. So it was learning about that and subsequently following them up in different directions and collaborating with them was where everything, much of my subsequent work emerged from. And it was an extremely stimulating period and a rather unusual one in some sense. All these different strands, I think, really sort of came together round about that time and all interacted one with the other. And of course, it was a few years later, I guess, that André Weil came to the Institute as well. But Borel was at the Institute. I'm not sure then, maybe a little later. So my memory of time is a bit confused. But and I went to Princeton many subsequent year occasions as well. But that first time, these were the kind of general, this is the general level of mathematics that was going on. There were other people involved, of course. There was Dean Montgomery, who represented the sort of topology of the more hard classical type and people who proved the Hilbert-Smith problem and that sort of thing. And of course, there was people like, there were the hard analysts like Berling and Selberg doing the number theory. But I had less to do with those. I don't think they, to be fair, had the same kind of big school. In fact, the interesting thing about the Institute of those days was the people who had the biggest effect weren't the main professors, they were the visitors. Yeah. I mean, the young chaps. And they were the people who, plus a few of the people at the university who were giving courses. And we used to go backwards and forwards between the Institute and the university, back constantly attending seminars there and coming back. I remember being this carload of people. Bott and Singer would go to these 3 days a week. We'd go to hear Kodaira and Hitzelbrook and so on. It was a very, very stimulating period altogether, and I think quite a remarkable period in the development of mathematics in the post-war era. Yeah. There was the big development in France, in Paris, with the Cartan Serre, but Princeton was where much of it was transported to and added to by the people coming from the other directions.